This is the man who had to propose legislation that the Jersey powers that be get together and talk to each other once every couple of months. But I will talk to him anytime he so chooses. Assembly Minority Leader Jon Bramnick, how are you, my friend?
Great, Steve. Just driving back from Trenton. $4 billion and more spending over the last 2 years. $34 billion goes to almost $38 billion. And it's 11% increase. I don't know who's getting an increase 11% out there in their wages, but I can tell you the state of New Jersey is spending more money.
Where are we getting this money is a stupid question, right?
From you.
Yeah.
They're getting it from you and your listeners, and they want to thank you for helping them out. Thank all your listeners because you just came up with $4 billion more money for Trenton so they can spend more money. You know they need it. Because they love spending money down there.
Oh, absolutely. And what are some of the things, what are some of the increases we're going to see?
You're going to see there's a lot of pork. There's $100 million in pork spread out. I'm not going to tell you each and every line, but I can tell you, you're not going to be happy with it.
No.
There's millions of dollars going to special pet projects. We thought we stopped that. Not anymore. And not only that, the Governor Murphy wanted to spend more than his Democratic colleagues. The fight was how much more to spend. So that's a pretty sick environment when the fight is whether you're spending $4 billion or more than $4
billion. You know what? And speaking of the fight, what's going on with Senate President Steve Sweeney and Governor Murphy? It's getting hot and heavy now. I'm looking at Sweeney's responses here to the governor.
Well, Steve is, let's put it this way, he's trying to be relatively reasonable. And he, you know, with respect to this governor, and, you know, he's a nice enough man, but he's extremely progressive. He's way to the left. And Steve Sweeney is an iron worker, and he gets it. And he's saying to this governor, listen, we're not going that far. We're not raising more taxes. So I give Steve Sweeney some credit, despite the fact that we should be at 2% cap, just the way every municipality is. And we're at 8% last year and 3% this year, 11%. I mean, that's completely nuts. So Steve's doing some good work, but with all due respect, when you have all Democrats and there's no balance of power down in Trenton, it doesn't work well. You really want balance in government, and we don't have it.
Well, some of the things that Sweeney had to say, he called Murphy is starting to resemble Donald Trump in bombast inconsistency and unreliability. The governor is repeating himself with a series of misguided and misinformed tantrums in an attempt to distract attention from his legislative and policy failures. His statements have been inconsistent on the facts, and they have become consistently wrong. These are two Democrats talking about each other. They're supposed to be in lockstep on the same page.
Well, I grew up in Plainfield, and on the playground, if your fight was just about to start, you go, I ain't playing with you. And that's what we used to say, right? Uh-huh. I don't think Steve Sweeney is playing with the governor. You know, this is serious, and this is very, very bad chemistry, as bad as I've ever seen it. The fight is, this is almost like a death match down there. But you understand that Steve Sweeney is saying to the governor, listen, we can't have new taxes. So I give him some credit. Mm-hmm. The governor wants a lot new, a lot more spending, and Steve's saying no.
And he has to. And you got to be going out of your mind watching all this down there. You had to propose legislation just to get them all to talk to each other. This is what happens when they finally do talk to each other. What are your feelings on all this?
Well, they're not talking to each other. They're talking at each other with separate press conferences. Look, if you run a corporation, it's required by law that you meet with the other board of directors. How do we have a state where the leadership of the state does not meet in a room? So I put a bill in, you have to meet a couple hours every quarter, come out and tell your stockholders, which are your taxpayers, how are you spending their money? We don't do that. They get into a fight, and it's all Democrats now. They get into a fight. What kind of report is there between this leadership? So I said, you got to meet once a quarter. You got to report to your stockholders, the taxpayers. You got to tell them what you're doing. So far, that's a Dracula bill. It's not seeing the light of day.
You know what? I think they'd be embarrassed to pass the bill because they'd be embarrassed to what would actually come out of these meetings. This is, like you said, you've never seen it this bad. I've never seen it this bad either. Where do you see it going from here? Like, how the hell do we get out of this mess?
How about elect some Republicans?
Maybe
but
idea.
Before we do that in November, this Sunday, I'm assuming that Governor Murphy is going to line item some spending in the bill. Mm-hmm. It's going to come back to the legislature, and it's going to be over. And then we're going to move on. There's going to be some money taken out, not a lot. And then we're back to square one, where the Democratic leadership isn't talking to each other, and it's press conference. It's fired by press conference.
And what about the millionaire's tax? Is that, like, finally over and done with?
Well, it's dead on arrival this year because there's a state election. Now, never count out Trenton from voting for another tax increase. You know, the state assembly's up this year. I'm the leader of the Republican Party. Mm-hmm. They're not going to pass that millionaire's tax this year. But I have to tell you, you know, if you've seen it in the past, you know, if a federal election is up and no one in the state is up, don't be surprised if you see it come back in the future.
Now, are we still $200 billion in debt? I just want to make sure.
Oh, absolutely. and it's unfunded liabilities that include pension, obviously debt, where we borrow money, and we only have a $37-plus billion budget. Can you imagine having revenues of $37 billion but owe $200 billion? That's exactly, you know, I'm not great in math. You know, I got about a C in algebra, but I can figure that sounds like you owe too much money.
You know what? We got to get you on the comedy stage, but it's like the big joke is what's going on in Trenton right now.
Well, I'll open for you anytime at any comedy club because you're the genius. I've seen you on stage. You're the genius of comedy in New Jersey.
John, we got to get you down here. Some night, like, why don't you come in? Like, we'll do, like, Ask the Assembly Minority Leader. You and me, like, 7 o'clock at night. When I get back from vacation, I'm off next week. We'll hang out and we'll take questions because there are so many people that hear this and they go out of their minds and they need someone they can talk to that they're not going to get the runaround from. And, you know, you just may be the one.
Well, grew up in New Jersey, love New Jersey, happy to come down there, hang out with you anytime. I'd love to be with you.
You got it. We'll also talk about why people don't like you, your new book.
Yeah, 200 rules.
Take it easy, my friend. Thanks for coming on.
Thanks, Steve. See you soon.